Welcome to December 30 daily current affairs. Today we have 5 major topics to discuss. Our topics include Central Pollution Control Board CPCB, darkening of Siang River, Uj project, advanced plant experiments or APEX, then the gallantry awards. Let us start with the Central Pollution Control Board. The Central Pollution Control Board or CPCB, it was recently in news due to the fact that it has conducted a study in 60 major cities of India, and this study has found out that around 4,059 tons per day of plastic waste is being generated from these cities. CPCB is a statutory body which was constituted in September 1974 under the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974. CPCB was further entrusted with the powers and functions under the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981. In addition to that, the CPCB, it also provides technical services to the Ministry of Environment and Forest of the provisions of the Environment Protection Act 1986. The major objectives of CPCB include protecting the cleanliness of water resources as well as improving the quality of air. Now, a major hot topic in today's news was with respect to darkening of Siang River. Now, recently what happened is that the Union government has conveyed its concerns to the Chinese authorities on the unusual darkening of the Siang River in Arunachal Pradesh. So, there has been this issue of darkening of Siang River in Arunachal Pradesh, and the official reports states that this darkening is caused by excess silt. But there hasn't been any findings about how this excess silt has been formed or what caused a deluge in silt was not found out. And there has been many debates and controversies regarding that darkening of the Siang River. China is saying that the darkening of the Siang River is caused by an earthquake in Tibet. But reports from Arunachal Pradesh and Assam is saying that the real cause behind the darkening of the Siang River is the construction of a tunnel by China in the Tibet Autonomous Province of China. See, this issue of the Siang River or Brahmaputra River has been a major bilateral issue between India and China as well as between China and Bangladesh. See, there has been in the past also, there has been multiple issues with respect to Brahmaputra River. Basically, China, most of the Chinese agriculture is happening on the northern provinces of China, and that is a very arid region which has water scarcity issues. So in the past, China has often tried to reroute the flow of Brahmaputra River into the northern part of China where the agriculture is happening. But this will be really, really affecting lower riparian states like India and Bangladesh. And recently there has been several news reports citing that China is right now trying to divert the waters of the river Brahmaputra into the western region of China called the Xinjiang region, but the Chinese officials have denied that kind of involvement. But anyway, this is a major bilateral issue between India and China, and there is a chance that UPSC can ask us a prelims question about the Siang River or Brahmaputra River due to this issue. They have already asked us a question with respect to Teesta River, since there was a bilateral issue between India and Bangladesh with respect to the Teesta River. So anyway, this is a huge, highly controversial issue. And recently, India has again taken up the matter with the Foreign Minister of the People's Republic of China. Now, about the Siang River. The Siang River, it enters India from Tibet, where it flows for around like 1,500 kilometers, and it is known as Tsangpo or Yarlung Tsangpo in Tibet. From there, it flows to Arunachal Pradesh, where it is known as the Siang River, and when it enters Assam, it is known as Brahmaputra. Then our next topic is the Uj project. Recently, the detailed project report of the Uj project was submitted by the Central Water Commission to the Ministry of Irrigation and Flood Control of Jammu and Kashmir. That is why the Uj project was in news. Now, the Uj project is a multi-purpose project in Jammu and Kashmir's Kathua district. Basically, this project is implemented in a river called Uj River, which is a tributary of River Ravi. Now here from the prelims point of view, what we need to understand is that the Uj project, basically the objective of the Uj project is to utilize India's rights under the Indus Water Treaty. That is the aim or objective of the Uj project. And with respect to the Indus Water Treaty is a water sharing treaty between India and Pakistan. It was brokered by the World Bank. Now again, there has been a lot of controversies regarding the Indus Water Treaty also. By the Indus Water Treaty, control over three eastern rivers, Bias, Ravi and Satluj, was given to India. And the control over three western rivers, Indus Chenab and Jhelum was given to Pakistan, and it is considered to be the world's most generous water sharing treaty. And there has been a lot of controversies regarding the Indus Water Treaty in India, especially after that 2016 September Uri attack. Then our next topic is APEX, or Advanced Planned Experiments. The scientists on International Space Station are harvesting plans for the APEX experiment. So that is why it was in news. The aim or objective of this APEX project is to study what will be the impact of microgravity on the development of roots and cells on plant seedlings. That is the objective of the APEX project. So it is to study the impact of microgravity on plant seedlings. Now the experiment uses the model plant called tail cress. Tail cress is grown on petri plates for a specified duration, and after that the plants are photographed, harvested and preserved, and they are further returned to earth for a detailed analysis. That is how this APEX experiment works. Another important report was that the International Space Station, it orbits earth once every 90 minutes. So due to that, the scientists on board will experience the New Year's Eve for like 16 times. Another important news report with respect to the International Space Station was that the ISS orbits Earth in every 90 minutes. So due to that, the scientists on board the ISS will experience the New Year's Eve like 16 times. Our last topic for discussion today is with respect to the Gallantry Awards. Now recently, why the Gallantry Awards was in news was due to the fact that the Defense Ministry, in coordination with the mygovernment.in, is conducting an online quiz with respect to the Gallantry Awards, and this is done in order to inculcate the spirit of nationalism. Now let us have a look at major Gallantry Awards. Mainly we have three major peacetime Gallantry Awards. First we have the Ashok Chakra. Ashok Chakra is awarded for valor, courageous action or self-sacrifice away from the battlefield. So it's a peacetime Gallantry Award, and it is the peacetime equivalent to the Param Veer Chakra, which is the highest military decoration in India. Kirti Chakra, then we have the Kirti Chakra. Kirti Chakra is second in the order of precedence of peacetime Gallantry Awards. Then we have Shaurya Chakra, which is third in the order of precedence. Then when it comes to wartime Gallantry Awards, we have the Param Veer Chakra, India's highest military decoration. It is equivalent to Victoria Cross. Victoria Cross was replaced once India gained its independence. Then we have the Mahavir Chakra, which is the second highest military decoration in India. And the Mahavir Chakra is awarded for acts of conspicuous gallantry in the presence of enemy, whether on land, sea or air. Then we have the Veer Chakra, which is third in precedence in the awards for wartime gallantry. So that's all about Gallantry Awards. And now for a more detailed look at today's Daily Current Affairs, you can download our Daily Current Affairs material.